Hello, Mark. Welcome to today's Engineer's Kitchen session. I want to welcome you here in Salzburg today. As we all know, you are one of our security specialists, especially on how to embed Zenon applications in existing IT infrastructures. Maybe you can give us a short overview of what kind of ingredients you brought with you today.
Thanks, Zaini. Today's topic, we're going to talk about how to integrate Zenon runtime into user administration in Active Directory.
Cool. So first of all, what are general reconsiderations when I want to integrate a Zenon application into an existing Active Directory infrastructure?
Yeah, so you have to consider your environment first. So is it actually an existing IT infrastructure with an Active Directory and domain controllers, or is it a greenfield and you need to set up domain controllers and you need to configure an Active Directory? It's not a trivial task if you don't have the necessary skills or know-how. So get the help of experts, that's my recommendation. If you need to set up an Active Directory for the use in the Zenon user administration.
So you mean you should get in contact with the local IT department before I start integrating anything?
Yes, talk with them, okay. Definitely. Zenon works best with a local dedicated domain. Mm-hmm. And the domain controllers ideally are situated on the OT side of the network. Mm-hmm. So there's no cross communication to the IT side.
So by OT you mean the operational technologies? So
that is correct. That's what actually the Zenon runtime system also resides.
So can you show us maybe something on how to administrate something like that in a Zenon application? Is there something I must foresee or do?
Yes. So the preferred method to get a link, establish a link between the user in Active Directory and authorization levels that are configured in a Zenon project is by configuring user groups. So in Zenon, in the user administration, it is possible to specify user groups. These user groups have a name and link to authorization levels.
So the Zenon internal authorization?
These are the Zenon internal authorization levels per project. Mm-hmm. The name of the user group in Zenon is matched to the name of the user group in Active Directory. So when an Active Directory user is logged in the runtime, it has a group membership. Zenon reads the group membership and matches the groups to the Zenon groups.
Okay, this is where the link happens.
The authorization levels are then assigned to the...
So this happens at the moment when the user starts the login, we retrieve the information from the Active Directory and merge this with the local information of the Zenon project.
That is correct. Okay. So the actual login is a two-step process.
Okay.
The Zenon runtime contacts on login contacts the domain controller of the domain by default of the user that has the domain user that started the runtime system. Then it reads out from the domain controller the information of the username that was used at the login, and it also retrieves properties of the user like group membership, password expiry information, if the user is enabled or disabled. And the next step is the actual login itself. And it's the interactive login type, basically the same login mechanism that is used when you log into your Windows workstation.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Is there also a way to predefine in the domain already this kind of user levels, or is this something I only can do locally in the Zenon project?
There are different methods. You can also define authorization levels in the domain controller.
Okay.
In the properties of the user, that's one mechanism. There's also a way that you can use a Zenon screen type, Active Directory user administration screen, to set properties of the user, create users, create groups, but also specify Zenon authorization levels directly at the user in Active Directory using a specific field of the user in Active Directory. And that's also the only way how you can get an administrator user, as administrator in the Zenon runtime, as a user right, as a user access right defined for an Active Directory user.
Okay.
If you use the user groups, there's no way that you can have an administrator user for the Zenon runtime as an AD user.
Okay. So, but this means also I don't have to leave the Zenon application also for administrating my users. So I have a dedicated screen type, which I can use to connect to the domain, administrate my users, my user rights. Also during the runtime, so I don't have go to go back to engineering just because I have a new employee in my facility. I can directly, during the operation of the system, re-engineer everything I need and continue working also with the new guy.
That is possible. It is however important to note that the local user, if there is an existing local Zenon user, it takes priority over an AD user with the same name. Yeah. So during the login mechanism. Mm-hmm. Also, you need to consider your workflow processes. So when you are managing your users, you need to have someone with the necessary skills and know-how, and also authorization to create those users and manage those users for you. When you use Active Directory users and someone leaves the company, it's better to disable the user than to delete the user. You still have your records, you still have your the user information in the main controller.
The data is still correct.
Is retrievable. So that's also something that's worth mentioning. If you display the alarm list and the chronologic event list, there's the column username, which is the short name that's used for login, and the user full name. Uh-huh. And the user full name for domain users is actually retrieved from Active Directory.
Okay.
And especially if you have very large domains where your users are coming from, retrieving that information can actually take a little while.
Okay. So we're talking about seconds, half a minute?
Well, yeah, it depends on where the domain controller is situated, how large your domain is. It needs to retrieve that information in order to display that in the list. So if you're not using that information in your alarm list or in your audit trail, but only in reports, you can increase the performance by just removing this column and not display it.
Okay.
There is a caching mechanism, so when it's retrieved once, the user full name will be cached until runtime restart.
Okay, that's good to know. Yeah. Okay, so until runtime restart. So after a new restart of the runtime, the user needs to log in one more time again so that the cache is filled again, and from that point on.
No, there's actually not a login required. So the runtime, when it opens the alarm list or the event list where this information is displayed, and it does it for the first time, it actually uses the user context of the user that started the runtime to read the information from the main controller. And that's also a requirement, right? Mm-hmm. So the user that starts the runtime needs to have the appropriate rights to retrieve that information.
Of course.
If you actually want to use a different domain since version 7.60, this is also possible. So in the properties of the user administration, the project properties of the user administration, you can specify whether or not the runtime for this specific project should use Active Directory users. And here you can specify the domain name that will be used to retrieve
the information from
about the users.
So I can use any domain here?
Important is that the user that starts the runtime has the appropriate rights to get the information from the domain controller.
That's interesting.
So if you have a domain trust relationship, the user that starts the runtime can be a different.
So this also means I can use cascaded domains and retrieve the information from a high level domain, let's say, even if my automation application is running somewhere outside in a subordinated domain.
At the moment in version 7.60, the login is restricted to a single domain.
Okay.
So you either use the domain that the user that started the runtime belongs to, or you use the domain that is specified here. You cannot specify the domain name at the login itself.
So Mark, this means these settings are made project specific. Is there any recommendation if I'm using more than one project in my Zenon runtime?
Yes, the actual user authorization levels are project specific. So in each project, you have different authorization levels. The user group names can be the same. So there's a group in each project. So we have operate 110 kV, so that's the high voltage part, and the low voltage part of the substation, for example, contains user groups for HVAC maintenance, but it may also be a viewer group. And it also exists in the other project. There's a mechanism that performs an automatic login of the AD user in all projects in a runtime. And the user rights are taken from the specific project. So again, in the project properties, user administration, there's the setting automatic login, logout in sub-projects.
Okay, okay. Okay, that's helpful, of course. So with one login event, I'm automatically logged in all the subordinated projects of my workspace.
Yes, with the corresponding authorization levels for each project.
Very good, very good. One last question mark. So we are very well prepared here. We can set a lot of things. What happens if the domain is not reachable? What can I do then?
Yes, you need to consider that, of course. The main controller can go down for maintenance, can have a fault.
A firewall can break down or whatever.
Yeah. So if the domain controller is not available and you're using solely domain users, then you will not be able to log into your runtime system. So there are different ways you can counter this. You can create a local Zenon user as an emergency user for the case when the domain controller is not reachable.
In the Zenon project.
In the Zenon project. You can also consider adding additional domain controllers, so backup domain controllers.
Okay, also a good idea.
Another mechanism is to use the cache credentials. So when you log in onto a workstation, Windows by default saves credentials on the local system.
Clear, yeah.
And Zenon is able to use those locally cached credentials. So you do have to explicitly configure this. And the way this is done is by configuring a specific user group for Active Directory login with cached credentials.
Okay.
We are not able to get the information from the domain controller. So this is why you specify a local Zenon user group. And those rights are then assigned to a user if they log in with cache credentials. This does lessen the security, or could potentially lessen the security, if an employee is leaving the company.
Taking the machine.
His domain user is disabled, and he goes to a workstation, unplugs the network cable, performs a login, he might still be able to log in with
again.
The cache credentials. So you do need to consider that, that if you disable users, that you also flush the cache credentials on all workstations.
Mark, thank you a lot. Thanks a lot. This was a lot of great information. It's really true. You are our COPA-DATA's OT security expert. Thanks a lot again. Here is your T-shirt reminding you of today's session. Hopefully we can make this soon again.
Thanks, Heini.
Bye.
It was a pleasure.
What a delicious episode of COPA-DATA's Engineer's Kitchen. If you are still hungry, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.